what we are going to do now is to go back to our Scratch project. And again, choose Scratch 3. Now, one thing to remember is that your models only last 24 hours. If you're doing this over the course of a few days, if you come here and it says you haven't built your model yet, you will have to go back to this step, the learn and test, and train your model again. Okay, so just don't get confused if you get to Scratch 3 and it says you haven't made your model yet. Just go back to the second step and retrain it again. All of your examples should still be there. It's just that the model will have to be rebuilt. All right, so we're going back to Make, back to Scratch 3. And now that we've got a model, it gives us some information about some of the new blocks that you'll be using. Now we're going to go into Scratch 3 and we will go over some of these blocks in there. So we'll say open in Scratch 3. Now my old project is not here, right? So that's why we saved it from before. So we want to use the code blocks from before. So let's go ahead and load from computer. My make me happy.sp3 that I saved before. Okay, so here's my code from before. Notice now that over here we have a new category in our blocks palette, make me happy. And these are the new blocks that are available. So what we are going to do is instead of our just two statements that we had to test whether something was a happy statement or a sad, we are going to now use our AI. What we're going to say, if recognize text, and let's go back and grab answer again. If we recognize the text of answer as, and then click on make me happy, as the happy label, then we'll switch our costume to happy. And then by the same token, we're going to, if we recognize our answer as sad, and let's make sure I grab answer. Okay, so let's test this out. So I'm going to go full screen and click my green button. And I want to be your friend. Happy, yay. Okay, let's try again. I don't like you at all. Sad. You notice that it's taking a little longer, and that's because it's working with the model. Let's try to get something that should give us just no change. What time is it? So note at this point, it's going to give us either happy or sad. So let's look back at our code. It's going to either recognize something as happy or sad, no matter what we put in. So if we want to keep it as the unsure or neutral, what we want to do then is go back here to our make me happy blocks. And we have this new block, recognize text confidence. So if you remember, we had confidence levels when we were testing. 100% means, yes, 100% I know this is happy, or 100% I know this is sad. Now, because we only have two labels, it has to pick one or the other. We want to make sure that it has really high confidence in either happy or sad for it to change the costume. What we need then is another if block, and that's in the control drawer. I'm going to drag this out, and let's drag out an operator, and this time we want a greater than operator because we want to test that number, the confidence level. And so go back to make me happy, and we're going to say recognize text confidence. And let's again from sensing grab answer. And probably 50 is a good number, so 50% confidence of that label. So if the confidence is greater than 50, then I'm going to switch the costume. So let's actually move this in here and then move that back. Okay, and then I'm going to do the same thing. So I'm going to duplicate this if block and we'll move out happy and put in sad. And then I can delete that block. So let's look at what we've got now. switch the costume to not sure to start, ask me the question, and then first it checks if it thinks it's happy, but then we want to make absolutely sure how high is your confidence that it's happy. And then we're going to do the same thing with sad. So first, do you think it's sad? And then with what confidence? And then this way we should get some unsures.
What's inside the if blocks, the switch costumes, will only run if both of the if conditions are true. So we have to have either a happy or a sad confidence level greater than 50 for it to switch the costumes. If it's not, it's going to skip right over both of these if blocks, so the not sure costume won't get switched.
So again, let's go back and test. We'll go to full screen and click the green flag. I want to be your friend. Makes me happy. Great. Let's click the green flag again. Go away. I don't like you anymore. Makes me sad. And let's try something that should not return either happy or sad. So something like, there is a bird at my window. Okay, and so it didn't change, and that's good. We don't want it to change because it shouldn't return a confidence level of more than 50% for happy or sad. So we have to have that other category that's neither happy nor sad. Now, you should probably go through the same steps you did with the Machine Learning for Kids website, where you test this out with a bunch of different inputs to make sure that your model really does work well with this Scratch project. But congratulations, you've just made your first AI project. Now you can go ahead and add to this if you'd like. Some ideas are, you know, each time you have to click the green flag to get it working, you could use a forever loop to just keep asking, type me a message. So think about that as a way to improve your projects so that you don't have to keep clicking the green flag. A couple of other ideas. You could use a different kind of sprite. You could use something like an animal. So, for instance, a dog, and the dog would wag its tail when you said something nice to it. Another idea is that you can have it respond to you. So you could have the sprite say something based upon whether or not you said something happy or sad. You could do that. But there are plenty of ways that you can improve on the project, and you could also improve on the model. So if you wanted to add more examples for these two labels, you could also add more labels. So add more emotions than just happy and sad. So you could have angry or excited or confused.
And what other ideas do you have? Try them out.
Now, one thing you do want to do is, again, make sure to save your Scratch project. So we're going to save it again. This time I would name it something like Make Me Happy AI version, so we can tell between our first version and our new AI version. So save that before you exit out. But congratulations, you've made your first AI project.